Hi guys, and welcome to the second season of Thunderstorms called Downpour. This series is written by Stacey Hall. Artwork was provided and approved by Sisset or Sisiet on Tumblr. I'll leave their link in the description box below, along with everyone that is collaborating within the series. Adrian and Cat Noir will be voiced by Shane, I will be voicing Marinette, Sabine and the narrator, Maddie will be voicing Tiki, Adrian's aunt Amelie and Rose, Keaton will be voicing Luca, Supri will be voicing a reporter, an officer, as well as a beach jock, Ashton will be voicing Plaque, Alia, Kagami, Jaluka, and Natalie. Chloe and Adrian's mother, Emily, will be voiced by Anna. Scott is going to be voicing Kim. Brad will be voicing Tom. Calvin will be voicing Nino and Hawkmoth. Nick will be voicing Felix. Frieza is going to be voicing Mark and Waze. Iris will be voicing Sabrina. Stormy333 will be voicing Milin. Nathaniel will be voiced by Dylan. Ivan and Master Fu will be voiced by Christian. Lila will be voiced by The Juicy Stuff. And Lee will be voicing Miss Bustier. Now, Chapter 8, Missing.
Ladybug!
He yelled through the harsh rainfall that could have muffled his yells. He searched and searched until darkfall. He honestly didn't care anymore if he got sick, or if he passed out from exhaustion. He needed to find her and convince her to stay Ladybug. He needed her. They had been through too much to just simply give up. Was it the pressure of their relationship and his father that caused her to do this? Was it the fear of Cat Blanc? Was it him that put too much pressure on her? Did he cause her to do this? He went to her home and opened the skylight, soaking wet. He climbed down the ladder and went to her bathroom and grabbed a towel and dried off. He went downstairs to her parents, who seemed to be extremely worried.
What's the matter?
He asked.
Oh, sorry. We thought you were Marinette. She went to a friend's house tonight and she should have been back hours ago. She isn't answering her phone and we can't get a hold of her friend or his father. We're super worried, Sabine said, trying to call someone.
I knew I should have trusted my gut. I didn't want her going to Adrian's house.
Tom shook his head. Cat Noir sighed and finished drying off.
I will go out and look for her,
he said, trying to seem like he wasn't out for the past few hours already.
Oh, thank you, Cat Noir. We're so lucky to have you.
Sabine smiled.
Yeah, no problem.
He forced a smile, heading back upstairs. A few days had passed and Marinette was still nowhere to be found. Her parents reported her as missing, and Gabriel Agreste was one of the prime suspects since he was the last person to have seen her, as well as Adrian. But he was quickly taking off since he was a minor and had no ulterior motives. Kenoir would stop by every single day at the Dupin Chang household and stay the night in her bedroom just to make sure she didn't stop by, but she never came home. Alia soon stopped posting on the Lady blog because Ladybug never came around. Cat Noir never gave the earrings to anyone else. He never took them to Master Fu. He was scared he would take them away. He wanted Marinette to have the earrings back. He would defeat the Akuma by himself as Mr. Bug and fix the city. He would not allow anyone to have Ladybug's Miraculous. He would hold both of them until she decided to come get them. She just needed a break. Everyone needed a break. Yeah, that's it. She just needed time. He would take care of Paris until then. What kind of partner would he be if he couldn't do that for her? Every night, as he would lay down in her bed, he would talk to Tiki and Plague, who would have mixed feelings about what he was doing, but his mind was already made up. He would take out his phone and send her texts about what was going on and what he was doing that day, as well as asking her what she was doing, though no text would ever come through. The next morning, he didn't have the energy to go to school and decided to just lay in her bed since the night before he had to deal with an Akuma by himself, letting Tiki and Plague talk as he stared out at the skylight above him.
Adrian, you can't keep both. You need to take one of us to Master Fu,
Tiki said.
Why can't he? It's not like he's abusing it,
Plague sighed.
Too dangerous for one person to have both,
Tiki said.
But he isn't hurting anything,
Flag argued.
Flag, you know the dangers. What if he gets akumatized? Then Hawkmoth has both. He instantly wins.
Tiki sighed. Adrian sighed, sitting up and stretching, not having the energy to even bother to argue with him. As he was getting ready to get out of her bed, he heard a thump above him, though he would have thought it normal, but it was a lot louder than a normal bird. He saw a shadow hover over the skylight and darted out of bed and transformed, quickly hiding below her bed. He heard someone coming inside the bedroom and making their way inside the bedroom and landing on the bed. Cat Noir jumped up and pounced on the person, hearing a scream.
Cat Noir? What are you doing in my bedroom?
Marinette said, confused.
Where have you been?
He said, tears almost filling his eyes as he wrapped her in an embrace. She said, feeling his arms around her. It was warm. She forgot what it was like. She wrapped her arms around him and smiled.
Sorry, she finally said.
Your parents reported you missing. You know how worried everyone was?
He said, leaning out and taking hold of both of her shoulders.
I needed to get away, Marinette said, feeling a little guilty.
Why didn't you send a text or something to let us know you're all right? At least your parents. I texted you every day. Why not text me back?
He said, frowning.
I'm sorry. I just couldn't. She said, turning away.
No, look at me,
he said, shaking her slightly to get her to look at him.
What do you want me to say? That I'm a coward? She yelled.
You're a what? No,
he said, letting her go.
That's what I am. I felt awful. I couldn't face anyone. I don't want to face anyone still. I was coming to get my stuff and leaving, she said.
No, you're not,
he demanded.
You're not stopping me.
Marinette tried to stand up, but Cat held her still.
You're not leaving again.
Watch me.
Marinette, stop this. You're Ladybug.
No, I'm not. Not anymore. I'm a coward who can't even face one man. One measly man named Gabriel Agreste. I'm not gonna get anywhere in life. Everyone knows that.
Prove them wrong. You can do anything. Just show them.
Cat Noir pleaded. His words caused her to go silent. She knew he was right, but she was scared. She was scared of failing. Scared of failing and everyone being right about her being useless.
I know you're scared. The day we met as superheroes, I could tell you were beyond scared. You were madly clumsy, but that didn't stop you. Being scared of failure didn't stop you,
he said. Marinette looked up at him.
Marinette, I can't do this without you. We're partners. I need my partner back,
he said, taking the earrings out and placing them back into her hands. He smiled and he gave her a nod.
Thanks, Adrian. I needed someone to talk some sense back into me,
she said, smiling and putting her earrings back in. She hugged him and felt him hug her back.
I'll always be here for you,
he smiled.
Now, where did you run off to anyway?
Cat said, leaning out.
I might have stayed at Master Fu's, Marinette laughed.
He let you? He didn't lecture you?
Yeah? Why do you think I came back?
Marinette laughed.
Well, I'm glad I have you back. Now, we need to fix everything. Everyone suspects my father of kidnapping you. Can you, fix that, Elby?
He winked.
I hate lying, but... she sighed. To make things simpler, I'll say Ladybug and you found me during the last Akuma fight last night. Sorry about not showing up, she said, kissing his cheek.
It was worth it,
he smiled.
But that plan is fine with me. I'll explain to your parents that I was simply too tired after the fight to tell them.
He smiled, holding up his fist. She smiled and fist-bumped her partner gently.
Want to go down there with me? She asked, climbing down the ladder.
I'll be there in a second, Bugaboo. I need a minute to myself,
he said, laying on his back in her bed. She smiled and went downstairs. A few seconds later, he heard a lot of movement, and voices coming from under him. He assumed they were hugging her, and wondering what had happened, he was glad she was safe. He was glad she had someone to talk things out with. He was happy to have her in his life, though they still needed to talk about them as a couple. He also needed to confront his father about him and Marinette. First, he needed to clear his father from being a kidnap suspect. He closed his eyes, finally being able to relax after the days she went missing. This was nice. Her room actually felt like home again. When she wasn't there, it was lonesome and saddening. But when she returned, it seemed like the sunlight filled the room once again. It was like a rainbow that pierced through the storm clouds after a harsh downpour. He sat up and walked down the stairs to find Marinette being crowded by Sabine and Tom.
Thank you, Cat Noir,
Tom called out, rushing over to pull him into a group hug.
No problem.
He forced an almost awkward smile, unsure how to respond. Marinette laughed and pulled away.
Well, did Marinette explain how Mr. Egress is no longer a suspect?
He said. Yes, we already called the officials and they cleared him. I'm glad, though when they were investigating Mr. Egress, they said they are keeping an eye on him for other reasons. They wouldn't let us know. They told us they would need to inform Ladybug and Cat Noir as soon as possible, Sabine said, a little worried. Cat Noir and Marinette exchanged worried looks.
Well, Mom? Dad? Do you care if I get caught up on some missed homework and take a shower? And maybe a nap? I'm kind of behind and... a little tired, Marinette said. Oh, of course, dear. We're so glad you're home. Be more careful around Akumas. We're going to get you a new phone since your last one was ruined.
Sabine smiled and hugged Marinette.
Thanks, Mom.
Marinette smiled and went upstairs.
I'm going to go see what the police needed. Hero's duty and all.
Cat Noir smiled and left, knowing Marinette would transform and meet up with him soon. Thank you so much for watching. The next chapter will be out soon. If you haven't already, you can check out my other series such as The Butterfly That Brought Us Together, A Monstrous Night, Melting, Thunderstorm Season 1 if you haven't seen it, or if you would like to rewatch it. Or you can check out my Christmas special called A Merry Cat Christmas Special, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!